What's up, guys? This is a very special video. I've been waiting for this to happen for the longest time. Finally, all of the stars have aligned, and in this video, I want to show you my ultimate iPhone X setup, a very unique setup. In fact, the only one of its kind in the entire world. I'll be showing you the iPhone X that I will be using as a daily driver. We've got all of the best upgrades I could possibly come up with all in one place, everything from software to hardware to accessories and whatnot. So in this video, I want to take you through that, walk through what's important to me on my iPhone, kind of like I did last year with the iPhone 7 Plus, but upgraded a little bit. So let's go ahead and do that without any further ado. The ultimate iPhone X setup. And here is Exhibit A. So very inconspicuous looking box, but inside we have a custom carbon fiber look wooden case. Super cool. Open it up. And it's assemble your own iPhone kit. This is actually custom work by Smartphone Schmied. I really don't know how to say that, but this guy does unbelievable things. And this is a glowing Apple logo kit for the iPhone X. Obviously mine's not finished because I couldn't decide between the final design. So I wanted to see that in person beforehand. But what makes this one unique and better than the one that I did is that it's actually CNC'd. It's done so much more professionally, no hack and tear job. It's actually very, very nice. And it's a white LED. So I'm gonna turn the brightness off here. It's actually a white LED. I told you guys it wasn't possible in the original glowing Apple logo video, and that was because a resistor wasn't added. We weren't getting the proper voltage. So I've got a couple choices here. First one being this one. This one is custom made for my channel. It's got my current logo on it, which I'm still thinking about changing. Really need to find a new designer. But anyways, so let's check out how this one looks before I make my final choice. And this part does not light up. I'm sure with some custom work it could be made to, but that actually looks super neat. We've got the green, the blue, the yellow. Wow, seeing that come to life, that's really, really something. So there's that one, but if I wanted more of an OEM Apple look like on the MacBooks or the older ones before Apple removed it, we've got just this regular one, and that is very, very clean. So we've got the Apple logo, clean white look. Yeah, I actually really like this one as well. This is a very tough choice choosing between the two. So I'm just gonna lightly apply this one for now. And there is that. I love how subtle it is, not too in your face, very refined, just elegant enough that it looks OEM. So definitely something I'd love to see. And in the dark, it looks just as great. Definitely a little bit more prominent, but it's so nice looking. The white on the iPhone X in space gray, it matches so well. And the cool thing about this is that even at low brightness, it remains at the same brightness. It does not rely on that like the iPhone 7 Plus, which may be a good or bad thing, you know. It was kind of cool to be able to lower it. But overall, it looks fantastic. So definitely one of my favorite additions to the iPhone X Plus. Any hardware modification that definitely voids your warranty, but in my opinion is one of the coolest things you can possibly do to an iPhone X. And next, to protect this beauty, of course, we're gonna need a case. And here is an updated version of one of my all-time favorite cases, second to the Pitaka carbon fiber one. This is the Advent Stealth Titanium case. One of the most expensive, if not the most expensive case you can possibly get for your iPhone, made of titanium. Very exclusive, only 500 of each type being made. Ooh, that looks great. So that's a stealth black look, and let's pop one of these bad boys out. That's nice, wow. So I think this is gonna work very well on the space gray. Wow, okay, let's try it on here. These things are not that easy to put on, but once they're on, they really don't like to come off. Wow, I am beyond stunned. This is one of the best looking combos, if not the best I've ever seen in my life. You've got black screen, black case, black back, a glowing Apple logo, and then the internal software that's also black with the dark mode, which I'll get into here in just a second, but wow, it is such a stunning combo. I think that looks fantastic. All right, let's delve a little bit deeper here and start getting into the software. What makes the phone a completely different experience from anyone else in the world? Oh, and can't forget these guys. So to go along with my space gray look right now, well, it's more of a murdered out look, but still, of course, the space gray AirPods. So these are provided by Colorware, and it's just another little layer of unique. You know, not a lot of people have these. They're very expensive, but so worth the money. Everyone has white AirPods, but does anyone have space gray AirPods? They've got a silverish look, very similar to the MacBook hue itself, not so much like the iPhone X. They're too light, but still, I love the matte feel. And I've been using these things for months, and it's still in such great shape, much better than the jet black version from the last video. So I absolutely love how these look, and they don't affect the performance in any way. Still AirPods, still get the same battery life, just have this unique look to them. So this paired with this look here, you get an all-exclusive, completely different experience, and that's what I love here. So space gray, murdered out look on all of these. And what better way to kick this off than to just show you? This is the coolest, seriously coolest tweak I've ever seen in my life. So this just came out, and it basically simulates a Pokemon battle every time you're getting a phone call. It mixes it up with new Pokemon, new trainers, you can do all the settings. Run is of course not to pick up. Fight is to pick up. Let's see what these do actually. Hide, actually. Oh, okay. So it hides the call and you can keep getting it while you do other things. That is so cool. And you have this little thing up here. This is so awesome. I cannot tell you how happy it makes me just to review this on camera. So I'm gonna try that again. Let's see what Switch does. Oh, okay, so FaceTime audio basically goes to the stock one. As you can see, it does a random one every single time. How cool is that, guys? Seriously, major props to the developer. This is PokeCall. Next up is an alternative to my all-time favorite tweak, and that would be Color Flow. This has to be the second best thing, as that one wasn't updated. But within the stock music application, all the album art gets basically colored into the background, into the buttons, and you get, alongside that, you can get a really nice music visualizer here, which for some reason seems to be glitching. Oh, there it is. So, it's just built in, super cool, dynamic, you know, response to the volume. And you can change the colors, of course. So let's try some new album art, just so you guys see the dynamic aspect of it. It'll change it to the most dominant color in the background, and then all the buttons accordingly. And there's a lot of black ones. It really likes to pick up on black. But if there's a colorful one, as you can see, it works with that as well. Some of the brighter artwork is pretty cool as well. So as you can see, pretty diverse. It's actually awesome. Now this one down here, the waveform, you can of course disable that, but it's active in many places. Here on the lock screen music player, you get the album art as a background. There's a lot of options here. And then you jump into here and you do get it here as well. So how cool is that? And by the way, what you're seeing here, this bounce, this is called a bounce tweak. And it basically, it's active everywhere in the iOS. It gives it a fun little, like, you know, bounce effect anywhere you go. So you jump in here, bounce, bounce, jump out, jump in here, click this, bounces. Now this next one is called Dot, and it's something that Apple really, really missed the train on. I don't know why they wouldn't do this. Every time you get a notification on the iPhone X, it gives you this little dot up here when your screen is off, basically letting you know what kind of notification you have, where it's from, and how many as well. So this is super neat, and it does go away after a while, so it doesn't burn into your screen or anything, but it's just so nice how easy it works. Apple definitely needs to do this. And next up, here's a very simple page transition called Barrel. It's been around since the dawn of jailbreaking, and it's just so nice to have on the iPhone X. Always one of my go-to jailbreak tweaks. By the way, everything that you're seeing requires Cydia on iOS 11.1.2 or up to 11.3.1 most recently. Personally, the iPhone from this setup is on 11.3.1, so it's being ready to be updated. This one is on 11.1.2, so I can show you all these tweaks that I'll be installing on that just as soon as I can. And a must right away, something that everyone has to struggle with, is the volume HUD. Aerify basically gives you this little one right underneath the status bar. It's dynamic, it goes away very, very quickly. You can change all the settings up on it. Very nice. I mean, I don't see why Apple hasn't removed it from the center of the display. It's been there for far too long. So here's another favorite of mine. This is Nude Keys on the bottom. As you can see, it gives your keyboard a gradient, which is really cool. And down here, you've got Barmoji with your most used emojis taking up that unused space on the keyboards. Whoops. So quite nice. Some optimizations here. Also here, Smooth Cursor. It gives you the Microsoft Word cursor, so it doesn't disappear. It kind of flows with your text. Very, very nice. And an absolute must. So you know how Apple doesn't let you actually turn off the Wi-Fi and Bluetooth? Well, with Real CC, you can. You don't need to go into settings to turn it off. This actually turns it off every single time, not just goes into that whiteout stage. This next one is implemented in iOS 12, but it's a must for iPhone 10 users on iOS 11. It allows you to just swipe up and delete, you know, the actual app switcher cards without having to hold them and then swiping them up. So very convenient. This one's actually great. You know how you can wake the screen of the iPhone X? Well, you can actually put it to sleep with a double tap using Tap Tap Sleep. on the actual status bar. So that's a nice little gesture, keeps the continuum flowing of the overall interface on the iPhone X. My mind still can't process to this day how Apple could release an organic LED iPhone and not have a dark mode. This is the best thing about jailbreaking. Hands down, number one is the dark mode. So you're able to get a completely black on black interface that saves you battery life, but also saves your eyes at night as well. You can enable it in many different areas, whichever app you really want, actually. Say in the App Store, very clean with the actual artwork in the background. My favorite app on the iPhone to use this in is in settings. It seems natural here. And also this animation here, this is called Cask. You get scrolling animations. We've got circle icons on the left. It just brings it together in this very neato way. So definitely dark mode is a must have. If Apple doesn't have this in iOS 13, I will break an iPhone just because of that. And again, one of the most useful tweaks ever is this type status. Know when someone's about to type and send you a message before they do it. This is basically witchcraft. Know when someone's gonna message you before they do, or they might start writing you and never finish the message, and you'll know. Oh, you'll know. And just a few more remaining, guys. So in the top right, what you're seeing here, that's percentage battery X, and you're able to get an actual battery percentage without having to go into the control center. It looks very clean. I see Apple doing that sometime in the future. Hopefully. In the camera app, this is a must. I've used it forever. The tap, tap, flip feature from Snapchat. You get so used to it that when it's gone, you're like, why not have it? So that brings out functionality to the actual camera. All right, guys, and there it is. Those are the tweaks that are my favorite. I can't live without them. Everything changes with time. There were a lot that worked on the previous version on the iPhone 7 Plus that don't hear anymore. So you kind of have to adjust, as the jailbreak scene is always shifting, always changing. And still, I'm very happy to the developers that even made this possible. My dream iPhone setup could not be complete without the jailbreak and all of the tweaks with it. So guys, I just want to say thanks for watching this video. I had a blast sharing my dream iPhone with you guys. Seriously, it is so cool to be able to do this. The fact that it's even possible and all of these companies coming together to make this possible. That was great. So thanks for watching, guys. Hope you enjoyed it. And if you guys will be jailbreaking, I highly recommend it. It's a lot of fun. And within the next few weeks or so, the jailbreak should be out for 11.3.1, and you'll be able to do that on your device. Stay tuned for the next year's version, guys. Peace.